Today I'm going to show you how I remove backgrounds from photos. So I've borrowed this photo from my friend Hannah. I'll leave her link in the description. So I'm using this tool up here. It's the quick selection tool. Originally I used to use the magnetic tool, but this has made my life so much easier. So all you do with this is adjust the size and paint into the areas that you don't want. So all I'm doing is highlighting all the background that I want to get rid of, and you can see that there's little dashes going around. I also call them little ants crawling around the screen, and it does a pretty good job. You'll see that it has like missed out her legs, so I'm just going to go in. I'm holding the Alt key and then I am clicking on her legs, and it is kind of picking up the areas that I want. This tool is really good, but sometimes it is a bit like iffy. It depends on if you've got a photo with a lot of contrast. If the background color is similar to the subject, then sometimes it is harder to use, but for a photo like this it's super easy, and it's made my life so much easier when editing photos. So when I have the basic outline, I'm just going to go in and get rid of the kind of hollows in between where her elbow is and her hand. I usually just go in, zoom in, just double check that I've got everything, because sometimes it does select the wrong bits. So you just need to hold the Alt tool and select it until you're happy. Like here, it has picked her hair up as part of the background, when obviously it's not, it's her hair. But once you have selected your kind of silhouette outline thing, you can then go into the Select tool up at the top of the page. And with the Select tool, I go into Modify and Smooth, and I have it set to 3. This might take a little bit of experimentation, but it just softens the edges. You want it to be quite a soft selection, so it doesn't look like you've just randomly stuck a person onto a new background. And then all you do is press delete and it will delete the background. As you can see on the bottom right, I duplicated the background just so I have that, just in case I did it wrong. But the basic premise is done. She's cut out. I did this in like 5 minutes. There are a few bits here that I've missed, so I'm just going to zoom in here, use the same tool again and just click the layer, get rid of the extra bits. And then I also use the eraser tool to get rid of any extra white parts or the background that I didn't want to keep. So that is basically how you cut out a background. It's totally up to you what background you'd want to replace it with. In this video you'll see that I'm just using a very random, quite garish colour to show you that there is just no background left and she's been cut out really seamlessly. So yeah, hopefully you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe if you aren't already for more tutorials on Illustrator, Procreate and Photoshop, and I'll see you soon for another video.